Good evening, Derby fans. I'm Raucous Ron here once again with Captain Lou Albamo. You're tuned in to the 2015 International WFTDA Division II Tournament Championship Game, live from Cleveland, Ohio, brought to you by the Women's Flat Track Derby Association and Burning River Roller Derby, whom we'd like to thank a lot. Tournament.
We do indeed, Raucous Ron. This is the gold medal matchup, the championship game. It's featuring the Kansas City Roller Warriors against Demolition City Roller Derby. Kansas City, of course, coming from Kansas City, Missouri, and currently ranked 45th in the Women's Flat Track Derby Association. They were the second seed in Demolition City, hailing from Evansville, Indiana, ranked 50th, and they were the 5 seed. Exciting action about to get underway, Raucous Ron. We're going to get skate in introductions from our in-house announcers, Mulligan and Scott Chicken, and I think we're going to head on over there just about now.
Okay. It is my pleasure to bring to you the Demolition City Roller Derby Dynamite Dolls. We've got number 0, Hertz Donut. Number 7, Jetsy Rocket. FR8, Boss A-Train. N0H8, Flexibel. Number 22, Bangs McCoy. Number 25, Lickety Splint. Number 31, Samich. Number 44, Steel Stitches. The captain of the Dynamite Dolls, number 75, Shelby in Pain. Number 81, Steffery. Number 82, Godzilla. Number 87, Splatter. 149, Bambi Thumper, and 1109, Tenacious V. That is the Demolition City Roller Derby Dynamite Dolls.
And their opponents in the black jerseys, the Kansas City Roller Warriors All-Stars. Number 3, Case Closed. Number 4 is Jesse Kaboom. Number 10, Enigma. Number 11 is Rump Wrecker. Number 24, Bruiser. 34 is Accelerator. Number 41, Mayhem Myers. Number AK-47 is Lady Killshot. 79 is Mary Lou Wretched. Number 84, Tough Noogies. Number 91, Foxy Brown. 118 is Raina Payne. 421 is Turtle Power. And number 501, AP Leisure, also known as Reptar. And that is the Kansas City Roller Warriors. Now looking at some jam.
All right. So, the makings of an incredible game here. You know, Kansas City coming in, the 45th ranked team, and the second seed, fought hard. They didn't have any dominating victories. They had to fight hard to get here past St. Chuck's Derby Chicks and Houston, and then Demolition City Roller Derby with a huge win, really surprising a lot of people over Treasure Valley, and then the big shocker of the tournament, taking down the 5th seed, taking down the number 1 seed, Santa Cruz, to end up here in the championship game. And that takes us to the line, and we're about to have a jam whistle.
Gold medal game, 5 seconds away from action, Raucous Ron.
On the jam line for the Dynamite, it's Bambi Thumper. For Kansas City, Mary Lou Wretched. Bambi Thumper caught behind Kansas City's wall early here. Sturdy, straight wall, but pushing forward, getting some position. Now Mary Lou Wretched, with one to beat, gets pushed out of bounds and will be cycled back. Kansas City does not seal it off, so they'll draw back
Yeah, we saw that
into
with
turn two.
We saw that with Demolition City in that game against Santa Cruz. Really solid defense, and they're using it against Kansas City to seal off their jammer right now.
One more to pass, and that's, oh, nice work getting past Enigma, who gave her a big hip shot, but staying in bounds on those toe stops. Bambi Thumper, first lead call of the game to Demolition City.
Bambi Thumper with 133 points over this playoff tournament already.
Yeah, quite the point scoring machine. And now scoring, boom, through the pack, pass, Bruce Herr picks up five. Demolition City on the board.
Mary Lou Wretched has removed the jammer cover from her helmet. It is a star stash at the moment, Ron.
Bambi Thumper up against Kansas City's braced wall. Enigma with the turnaround brace. Now getting some motion out of the front. We'll see a penalty on the front end for Demolition City. That is a forearm. Meanwhile, a star pass. That is to Bruise. But the damage is done. 10 points on the board for Demolition City. Coming out strong.
Hard-grinding first jam of this championship matchup. Demolition City drawing first blood.
And now Kansas City's top jammer of the year, case closed, with 620 points this season, steps up to the line against Hertz Donut.
Yeah, case closed getting 126 points over this tournament. Hertz Donut held to 47. She's had some difficulty to getting through. We'll see what she can do against this back wall.
Hertz Donut up against the braced wall. Once again, Enigma with the turnaround blocking. Case closed. Oh, busting through on the inside. Case, one of those people who can really create a hole with the upper body shot on the blocker.
It hurts Donut still stuck behind that wall.
Case is pushing, really getting motion. And now out of the pack is Hertz Donut. But Case through and calling it off, putting Kansas City on the board.
Yeah, and we also saw that with Demolition City against Santa Cruz. Very good at getting their jammer out, limiting the number of multiple pass scoring passes for the opposing team. Kansas City grabbing 4 points, closes the gap to six. Demolition City with 10, 27 minutes remaining in the first half of the game. On the fast girl start line is going to be AP Leisure. And number 25 for the Dynamite Dolls, that is Lickety Splint, who has 135 points in this tournament. She is the lead jammer for her team.
Yes, and a pleasure with 143 points for Kansas City's leading scorer. So good matchup here as they come into turn one. Lickety Splint knocked to the outside. A big shot from Enigma, and we'll see a lot of those today. Accelerator drawing her back, almost draws the cut track on Lickety Splint. Still struggling with the front wall of Demolition City. A pleasure. You'll see on her jersey says Reptar. She doesn't mind going by both.
A pleasure knock to the outside. She's going to have to reset, Ron. That's going to allow lead jammer to go to Demolition City.
Yeah, nice toe stop work on the side there. A pleasure getting knocked around but stays in bounds now. Getting a little push from Bruiser out of the pack. Coming in scoring position. Look at he's been, ooh, slides around that big hit from Enigma. So not a big hit.
Yeah, nice escape move on the part of Lickety Splint. Grabs those 4 points, gets the lead back to 10. Two blockers in the DerbySupply.net penalty box for Demolition City. The Dynamite Dolls are going to be underpowered as this jam gets underway. 4-on-2 blocker advantage for the Roller Warriors from Kansas City. It's going to be Jessica Boom, who has been a revelation this weekend, Ron.
Yes, Jessica Boom from the rookie program in Kansas City. Skated in one game before this and has lit up this tournament, really impressing a lot of people. Now coming up against the two of Demolition City, now three with one out of the box. Bambi Thumper slides by on the outside for lead.
Sometimes experience pays off as well.
Jessica Boom, boom, look at that. Oh, living up to her name, but look at the blocking going on in the front end.
Alexabelle going to war at the front with Jessica Boom.
Wow. Ringing the bells up there. Or booming the bells, I should say.
Booming the bells. 4 more points for Bambi Thumper, but the thumping that we were watching during that jam was the jammer versus blocker action at the front of the pack. If the game goes like this, there's going to be some very sore individuals by the end of this game.
Yeah, Kansas City was taking some ice baths last night, so
Demolition City now leading by 14, 18-4 is the score. Fast Girl start line is going to see Hertz Donut for the Dynamite Dolls and Turtle Power.
Turtle Power, first appearance in this tournament. A transfer to Kansas City mid-season. Pushing the back wall, but pushing way up front. Hertz Donut getting some real traction on the front and stays, gets the cut. Toe stop, slipped out of bounds in turn two. Will take a seat in the DerbySupply.net penalty box. We have a Star Stash. And Turtle has it back on, now into scoring position, getting ready to score the first points of her WFTDA tournament career. You gotta love that. How exciting.
First, she has to get past Steel Stitches.
Did not go out of bounds and stays in. That's exciting for the folks back home in Kansas.
Now, she's not lead jammer, so this jam will go the full 2 minutes, Ron.
Turtle Power now exits on the far side straight away. Boom! Look at the hit from... it was somebody awesome. So big hit, and now turning back into Turtle Power, still trying to fight the way through. Back on the track is Hertz Donut. Exits the track and has to step the wide way around. Picks up the cut track, kind of fell back inside from the entrance of turn one.
So double penalties for Hertz Donut, two power jams.
That hurts, don't it? And getting some offensive help up front. Turtle Power. Now a sweeping block from Kansas City. That's good offense, and really happy to see that. I'm sure they are.
Yeah, it's something that's been missing from their game all weekend long. Nice to see it being brought to the championship game, Ron.
Yeah, Turtle Power once around. Back around into turn two. The jam will end on time with Kansas City closing the gap to four. Closing the gap to two, Kansas City 16, Demolition City 18, 22 remaining in the first half.
Powerdyne, cutting edge designs, cutting edge performance. Powerdyne, part of the Rydell family. So on that Fast Girl start line, we're going to see Mary Lou Wretched taking the star, still in the DerbySupply.net penalty box is sitting Hertz Donut. So this is a power start, Ron.
Mary Lou Wretched trying to go up the middle into turn one, runs into a tough wall of braced blocking, but finds a lane on the inside. Lead jammer, Kansas City, Mary Lou Wretched.
Power jam over as Hertz Donut returns to the track.
Hertz Donut lateral movement from side to side. Mary Lou also enters a big cluster of blockers grinding together. Now, initial pass completed by Hertz Donut. Mary Lou in the pack trying for those last points. We'll call it off at the last second.
Checking the score, 2 points total for Kansas City. We've got ourselves a tie, 9 minutes gone in this championship game, and it's like we never even started. We're going back to stage one. Turtle Power, 12 points so far in this game. 14 for Bambi Thumper on the Fast Girl start line. Will be Bambi Thumper. It's going to be case closed for the Kansas City Roller Warriors.
Case closed, jumping into the fray. That nice hip twisting action around the outside, gets knocked out. Bambi Thumper drawn back.
Bambi Thumper did get lead jammer before that drawback happened.
Oh, now drawn back again. Of course, Case is as well. So some good defense from both teams on the front end of this jam, but Bambi Thumper coming out in scoring position. We'll see Enigma headed to the penalty box. Case closed, knocked to the inside of turn two, has to crawl back in. Now holding on to that star in her hand.
The Dynamite Dolls with all four blockers on the track remain very difficult to get past.
Bambi Thumper, those juke moves are just crazy. And it was a star stash, so Case now out. Bambi will call it off and not risk the points coming in for Kansas City.
Yeah, that back wall of Roller Warrior blockers was too intimidating, especially with case closed, closing quickly. Score is now 23-18 in favor of the Dynamite Dolls. 19 minutes and 30 seconds remaining in the first half. Sin City Skates, we don't sell it if we wouldn't play in it. SinCityskates.com. And lining up on the Fast Girl start line will be number 82, Godzilla. For the Dynamite Dolls, we haven't seen her jamming too much this weekend.
Yeah.
A pleasure will jam for Kansas City.
Godzilla around the outside, but nope, it's a pleasure for Kansas City, now halfway around into scoring position.
Yeah, and the lead jammer had actually been earned by Godzilla. It's another one of those situations where the Kansas City Roller Warriors haven't been able to always stop the jammer from Demolition City from picking up lead jammer status, but they're not stopping blocking once that lead jammer status has been grabbed. They knock the jammer to the inside, get the drawback, and they're able to force the call off after their jammer gets out. It's great that they're not just taking that double whistle as, oh, we have to let her go. Still within the zone of engagement, still legal target.
Lickety splint for Demolition City. Jessica Boom for Kansas City. Lickety splint. Possibly no pass, no penalty again. Going around to Kansas City blocker. Knocked to the outside now by Bruce. Both recycling back into turn one. Little jammer on jammer defense.
The captain, Shelby and Payne, heading to the DerbySupply.net penalty box.
Wow. Bruce continuing the attack. And once again, knocking right out of bounds. I believe that is three or four times on that jam so far.
A low block assigned to Jessica Boom. She'll sit in the DerbySupply.net penalty box. She'll be joined there by Flexibel. And penalty parade for the Dynamite Dolls. It's going to be Bangs McCoy hitting the box as well, but they've got the only jammer on the track.
Yeah, and having a tough time in this jam with Kansas City's defense. Numerous times sent to the outside, having to get up off the ground this time, slowly coming back, maybe a little worn down. Now getting some offensive help, comes in face-to-face with Enigma. Nice slamming movement up front. We'll see a forearm on Enigma. And you've got to watch out for Enigma. Enigma will get some penalties in a game, and it's early.
Bruiser draws the track cut on Lickety Splint.
So now on the power jam for 24 more seconds in this jam is Jessica Boom. Jessica Boom. Bruiser gets knocked to the ground by a big block.
Yeah, a huge forearm, and then a failure to reform sends Shelby and Payne to the penalty box as well.
Wow, yeah, like you said, a parade to the DerbySupply.net penalty box. Jessica Boom comes up on the pack, now getting some help from Tough Noogies.
Time's going to run out in the jam, looking to see how many points were scored. Nothing to nothing. Scoreboard's going to remain 23 apiece.
Just what we expected,
yeah,
really.
You know,
a tough, you know, contentious battle here. I'm loving it.
Yeah, I mean, and we say that lackadaisically, like, oh, it's what we expect from roller derby. It's what we expect. But, you know, it's one of the things about the Division II playoffs that I love so much is that you don't know who's going to win, and you don't know how the game's going to turn out, but you're almost always guaranteed that you're going to have a close game. And we've had some fantastic games all weekend long. If you're wondering how this weekend has turned out for the teams, in 10th place was Treasure Valley. They started as the 4 seed. 9th place was the Columbia Quad Squad. They were the 3 seed. Oklahoma Victory Dolls end up in 8th. They were the 9 seed. Jet City Bombers in 7th. They were the 8th seed. Brandywine Belligerents, 6th. They were the 10th seed. St. Chuck's Derby Chicks, 5th. They were the 7th seed. Houston Roller Derby, 4th, they were the 6th seed. Santa Cruz Boardwalk Bombshells end up in 3rd. They were the 1st seed. The only team left in this tournament that can finish in the seed they entered is Kansas City Roller Warriors, and that would require them to lose this game. I suspect they have no desire to do that.
That's right, but I think either one, certainly from what we've seen, can take this one. Depends on the fates and fortunes. Back on the line, we have Bambi Thumper and Turtle Power. Turtle Power coming through on the inside lead. That'll be exciting for Kansas City fans to see the all-star rookie performing well in the beginning of this one. Now into the pack, picks up points, calls it off. No, does not pick up points. I guess did not get in front of a blocker.
Yeah, had to call it off as the hustle was on. Steffery hitting the penalty box for Demolition City. They did clear out the remainder of their blockers. They'll have three blockers on the track. Still four blockers out there for Kansas City. They'll send Mary Lou Wretched to the Fast Girl start line. It's Hertz Donut jamming for Demolition City. Score remains 23-23, 15 minutes and 30 seconds remaining in the first half.
Pack all clustered together in one big pile. Now getting some separation as Mary Lou is pushing the big blockers up front and picks up lead for Kansas City. Two more blockers headed to the box.
Steffery's already in there, so only one blocker left on the track, and a track cut is sending Hertz Donut to the penalty box. Another penalty for the jammer from the Dynamite Dolls.
Yeah, starting to be a little bit of an issue there. Mary Lou, not many blockers to get past, now getting some offense. Big hit from Enigma in the front end. And wow, speaking of big hits, Steffery putting Mary Lou Wretched on the ground. Mary Lou battling hard. Now out of play penalty called on Steffery, and Mary Lou comes around with five more.
Yeah, Lady Killshot also getting that failure to reform penalty. She joins in the penalty box.
Only three blockers on the floor total for both teams. Micro pack here as Mary Lou comes up with one blocker to spin around. And oh, gets knocked down. An excellent work by Steel Stitches.
Yeah, big hits all around in this jam. Penalties being dished out. And Steel Stitches will head to the penalty box for her efforts. There are two in the box right now. Just one in the box. That's Steffery back in the penalty box. Bangs McCoy has three trips to the box. Hertz Donut also three trips to the box. And so does Flexibel for the Dynamite Dolls. Dynamite Dolls doing a pretty good job of keeping penalties off the board during this weekend. They've averaged 31 per game, but they're really starting to rack them up in this first half. They've got 15 trips already, Ron.
It's like Demolition City wasn't even ready because the case closed just sailed right through. And kind of caught him by surprise on the outside, untouched, and then now through, pinballing through the two blockers. Demolition City's got to get these blockers back on the track and keep them there.
Yeah, it's not just jammer penalties that hurt you. Too many blocker penalties will shut you down.
It's like a little hurting going on out there, and adding insult to injury, a case comes in and gives her another knock.
Yeah, Lickety-Splint is down. The jam's going to get called off because of it. Crawls off the ref lane. But yeah, just a hard hit in that pack sends her to the ground. We get ourselves official timeout. The difference is now 15 points. Kansas City with 38, Demolition City with 23. Official timeout stops the clock at 12 minutes and 59 seconds remaining in the first half. But yeah, penalties 15-8 so far in this game. Kansas City skating cleaner during the tournament. They actually picked up 13 more penalties per game than Demolition City committed. And that's really reversed in this game. That's given Kansas City a 20-point lead now, 43-23 over Demolition City.
I noticed they were tied on jammer penalties, though, for the tournament, 16 each for the first two games. Kansas City was able to pick up lead 61% of the time in the first game and 40% in the second game. Demolition City picked up lead 83% in the first game and only 38% in the second game. So both teams having a rough time in the second game with lead calls, but winning nonetheless.
Winning, that's right. Winning,
that's the important part.
Winning is what you want to do. On the Fast Girl start line, we're going to see a new jammer for Demolition City. She did jam in the first game of the weekend. It is Flexibel. She does have three trips to the DerbySupply.net penalty box, and it's going to be a pleasure for Kansas City Roller Warriors.
Flexibel can play either jammer or blocker, traditional blammer. Both engaging. Defensive walls breaking down up front for Demolition City. Nice juke move. Took one of the skaters, the blockers, to the ground, and a pleasure to be lead jammer.
Yeah, it's going to be splatter heading to the penalty box for Demolition City. Penalty woes still continuing for the blockers out there, doing a good job of holding A Pleasure back, but she gets through Ron for 5 points.
Yeah, again, another good juke move. Really quick lateral movement for this young jammer with a bright future. Fantastic. Leading point scorer in this tournament for Kansas City continues the point scoring domination, coming around for another five.
Yeah, she's got 10 so far and just crushed to the outside. That was Shelby in pain with a big hit. One additional point grabbed as the jam gets called off.
Yeah, it gets a little turbulence coming into the back.
Yeah, sorry, that one point, was grabbed by Demolition City. 3 points grabbed by Kansas City. Kansas City now at 53, Demolition City at 24. 11 minutes, at 56 to 24. 11 minutes and 40 seconds remaining in the first half. Be a lifer, get a lifer. S1 Helmets, S1Helmets.com.
Jessica Boom and Bambi Thumper. Jessica Boone to the outside, Bambi Thumper to the inside, gets recycled by Bruce. Now shoved to the inside in turn one. Jessica Boone comes back in along the outside. Oh, knives through, picking up lead, Kansas City. Bambi Thumper not too far behind and trying to close the distance with some quick skating. Jessica Boom looking to get in and calls it off. Astutely done by the rookie.
3 points grabbed. Kansas City now at 59. The Demolition City's 24. Penalty box has cleared out. So we will get 5-on-5 roller derby action underway on the next jam. It's going to be number 82, Godzilla, taking the star for the Dynamite Dolls. And it's going to be Turtle Power, who has 12 points in this game for Kansas City. Kansas City lead jammer over the past five jams, Ron.
Ooh. Turtle Power pushing on the inside, now gets knocked down by the captain, Shelby in pain. And we have a cut track on the floor. That will be Turtle Power.
Yeah, Shelby in pain popped back, was complaining that she didn't get the track cut. It was granted by the outside
and
pack.
And another
ref.
Cut track
on
the floor for the jammer from Demolition City, Godzilla.
So we'll go the full 2 minutes once the jammers get released from the DerbySupply.net penalty box. Neither jammer eligible to score yet. So they'll be on their initial passes still.
Kansas City had a blocker trapped in the back. Now Turtle Power falling down in the back of the wall, braced by Steffery and company. Knocked to her knees, getting up slowly, a little wind knocked out there, now crawling. And
yeah, that was a hip straight into her gut, and she had the wind knocked out of her. If you've ever had that happen to you, it is just one of those things that it completely shuts down your system. There's nothing you can do about getting back to the feet. Doesn't necessarily cause permanent injury, but you are stuck for a minute or two so you can recover your wind.
It's happened to me many times. It is uncomfortable, but I'm pretty sure she's all right out there.
So penalties so far in this game, 22 for Demolition City. Kansas City remaining at 9. Now, one of the interesting things about Kansas City is that those 9 penalties, that's really important for them to keep their penalties down. They run a very tight blocker rotation.
That's
We've
right.
had 15 jams in this game so far. Enigma's been in 15 of them, Bruiser in 14 of them, and Tough Noogie's in 10. So if those players start getting in penalty trouble, you know that they're going to have to start digging into their bench, and they've got a lot of players who have not played many jams in this game. You come in, you're a little cold, you're not ready. It can really change the momentum. So they're really relying on those veteran blockers. It's paying off so far, but it's a little bit high risk, especially as the game gets going. A Pleasure is back up on her feet, Ron, and she seems to have regained her wind. Turtle Power.
So, interestingly, yesterday, Enigma fouled out after 35 jams. She had played all 35 jams.
She does not miss
around. Did not step off the track until she fouled off the track. Bruiser played in 35 jams in the whole game. That was pretty extraordinary.
Rydell skates made in the USA, made for derby. Rydell skates, you can find out more about them at rydellskates.com. Get the rolling whistle, which means derby is about to get back underway on the fast girl start line. It's gonna be Steffa Reeve going up against Mary Lou Wretched.
Yeah, Demolition City will mix it up with these blockers, sometimes sending in, I mean, with the jammers. Steph Reeve gives a good change up, you know, a different style, very forceful, pushing her way through typically as thus.
Yeah, it can be really tough to put the star on her head because she's such a great blocker, but she's doing a good job here.
One to the penalty boxer for each team. Now another one for Demolition City. Four picked up by Steph Reeve.
Yeah, Splatter and Boss A-Train to the penalty box. Looks like it was Bruiser who is standing in the penalty box at the moment. And yeah, more penalties for Demolition City. They're going to have to get that under control.
On the fast girl jam line, case closed for Kansas City and Bambi Thumper for Demolition City.
All your derby needs, derbysupply.net. Just hit it.
Two on two blocker situation. Bambi Thumper running right up the middle through the rabbit hole goes Bambi.
Yeah, Demolition City really needs her to start stepping on the gas and getting points on their side of the board if they want to catch Kansas City.
That's right. So good at finding a hole where there is none, as we saw against Santa Cruz. That time unable to come through. No points scored. Did not get the hip around the big blockers for Kansas City.
Yeah, Lady.
Her pumping the fist in the air.
Yeah, Lady Killshot and Rump Wrecker doing a good job of holding back. The score is 59 for Kansas City, 28 for Demolition City. 7 minutes and 50 seconds remaining in the first half of this game. Lining up on the fast girl start line will be Steffery. Once again, Demolition City liking what they saw the last time she was out there.
Exactly.
A pleasure taking the star for the Kansas City Roller Warriors. A little bit of aggression before the whistle.
Right, and possibly needing someone with some strength to push. Right now pushing on, but coming out as lead is A Pleasure.
Jailbreak from the Demolition side of the penalty box gets all four blockers. Not three blockers on the track. Man, they're just really keeping them in there. 2 points snagged at the end of that jam. Kansas City now at 61. Demolition being held off the scoreboard yet again. Difference is now 33 points with 7 minutes remaining in the first half. Jessica Boom's going to get another shot with a star in her head for the Kansas City Roller Warriors, and it's going to be Bambi Thumper for Demolition City.
One in the penalty box for Demolition City. Tough noogies. Big bump on Bambi Thumper. Now, almost found the hole on the inside, but filling in the gap was the enigma that is Enigma Fitzgerald. And a penalty, a forearm penalty on Jessica Boom. So power jam Bambi Thumper, and she might get some offensive help out here.
I don't think she knew.
Yeah.
I mean, she absorbed another big hit from Enigma. She went down on one knee, made it out, got that lead jammer status, but then called it off right away because she knew that the other jammer had gotten out of the pack first. Unfortunately for her, she did not know that jammer was sitting in the penalty box.
Yeah, and you got to wonder how many of these body shots and bruises over the weekend come into play make a difference in the performance on the final day. Tournaments are so much of an endurance activity. And much different than just showing up and playing one bout on the weekend. Coming around that wide edge is Steffery and picking up lead, just forcing through on the outside edge. And now into scoring position. We'll get some offense from the captain, Shelby in Payne.
Jesse Rockett also chipping in there.
Has the motion going. So good at holding that outside line and just pushing the blockers into open space. They had to let her go. Now in turn three, looking to do the same thing. As comes up, slides around Enigma. Steffery, not exactly one you can bump out with ease. You've got to be really committed and all the way to the line.
Maximum effort is required.
This was a good mix-up for Demolition City.
Tough noogies to the DerbySupply.net penalty box.
Steffery stays in bounds, just looking down at her foot. Very good veteran move there.
Yeah, she used every inch of the track on the outside of turn three.
Looks very calm, cool. Look, taking on Enigma. Enigma now getting the best of her, crumbles her to the ground, and she will call it off from the ground as Jessica Boom was coming around in scoring position. Picks up 3 points. Kansas City 61, Demolition City 45. 4.5 minutes remaining in the first half.
And we've seen this all weekend long. Doesn't matter how big your lead is, what the momentum's like. In the blink of an eye, it can shift, and all of a sudden Demolition City is crawling back into this game. 16 points is the difference. It used to be 33. Steffery is now the lead scorer for the Dynamite Dolls with 21. On the fast girl start line is going to be Bambi Thumper against Mary Lou Wretched.
Great adjustment with Steffery. Bambi Thumper looking for a hole on the inside. Dances by, falls back in, has to run back around to the jammer line to recycle in behind a Rump Wrecker. Doing an excellent job in this tournament. And Bambi just, boom!
Hammer and nail.
That is right. Set up by Bruise and taken down by Enigma.
Amazing agility on the part of Bambi Thumper to stay in bounds.
And now Mary Lou recycled to the outside by Splatter. Drawing the pack back, they are bridging. Bambi Thumper still looking for space.
Completed a whole lap, almost a minute of this jam gone. Nobody has got lead jammer yet.
I love defense. Defense is so awesome. You don't have to be scoring points to have fun.
Now you're at that stage of the jam where the jammers are getting a wee bit tired.
Bambi, they just keep on working though. Pack starting to collide together for turn one, but pushed to the outside and looking a little bit winded. Mary Lou, Bambi, that side-to-side motion seemed to be slowing down a little bit up there, Captain Lou.
Yeah, she's looking a touch tired. Direction of gameplay is going to get
Rump Wrecker.
Rump Wrecker to the DerbySupply.net penalty box.
Whoa, there we go. Finally, 18 seconds left in the jam.
And it's a forearm.
My goodness. Mary Lou.
Boos from the crowd.
Yeah, they were kind of happy to see somebody finally get out. But defense, I love this defense. Oh, strong.
Yeah, big hit by Tenacious V and then the revenge hit by Tough Noogies down on the outside. Mary Lou Wretched slow to get up. One of the things about the jammer rotation that Demolition City has been running, they've been running Bambi Thumper and Steffery back to back for the last six jams. She's in the penalty box right now, but she was beaten up for a minute and 40 seconds in that jam. She's got to be exhausted. You wonder if Dynamite Dolls are going to be able to continue with that rotation base. Case closed, we'll get the power start though.
So Case, difficult to stop. And just about any time now taking on the front wall, bashing, gets separation. Looks like we've got, it's getting pretty spread out there. Now the pack finally called.
Stretched out at the front as Flexibel finally tumbled to the ground.
So Bambi Thumper after that jam, stepping back in. Bruce always looking to draw that cut track penalty.
Star pass to Steffery.
Hey, that's a pretty good idea about now. Steffery.
Nice quick reset to get back on the track.
Steffery not afraid to take on Enigma chest to chest. And most people avoid Enigma like the plague, like that.
Yeah, Steffery, a real standout for her team. Three more points by Kansas City. 69 is their total. Demolition City at 45. Difference is 24. Getting down to the last jam territory with only 25 seconds remaining in the first half. Adam skates, train hard, play hard, or play smart, and skate Adam, adamskates.com. And for potentially last jam of the first half, Hertz Donut will face off against A Pleasure.
Pleasure tries the outside, now driven to the inside. Did not go out of bounds, but almost looked like she did. Almost a fake there. So I didn't. You got to hope the ref saw that too. And Joe, look at that footwork. Oh, finally gotten on the front end by Splatter, but no, committed a penalty, so we'll continue on.
Yeah, Splatter about 50 feet away from the pack, heading to the DerbySupply.net penalty box.
And Reptar calling it off after four more, extending Kansas City's lead to 73-45, and it is halftime. What an exciting
first
half.
That half absolutely flew by, Raucous Ron.
It did.
28-point lead for Kansas City Roller Warriors. But it was a hard-fought 28 points. You got to wonder what Demolition City can do to get back into this game. They've got to get playing the way that they played in the first two games this weekend. They've got to have a little bit of what we like to call believance. There's a hashtag in front of that.
That's right. So, you know, and I was impressed at their adjustments, though. You know, putting in Steph Reed, that sort of thing, you know. So they've got the makings there. They've just got to go back and think it.
And we're just waiting for the Booty Basket Award to get ready to be sent out. So we're going to need a microphone for people to do that. Yeah, I mean, it's been a fantastic first half. And Kansas City doing what they need to. They've brought some new jammers into the rotation. And the hard-working blockers still getting it done. I'm seeing Ryan Will heading to the center.
Because we are here now to call the winner of our Booty Basket. It's obvious you're here for some great roller derby, but you were also wise enough to stick around for our Booty Basket drawing, which we're going to do right now. I want to take a moment to thank our great partners here in venue for providing the prizes. Over $200 worth of prizes given to us by Next Level Skate Shop, Adam Skates, Derby City Skate Shop, Crooked River Junior Derby, Burning River Roller Girls, and of course, yeah, and some great WFTDA merchandise. So Waggle is going to draw a name, and that name is Tommy Sullivan. Where's Tommy Sullivan? People know him. I'm guessing some people love him. But if he's not here, he's not going to win. Oh, not here. Are you just saying that? You want another chance. So we are going to try this one more time. Let's see. On this side, where is Woe Nelly? Ah, this is what I like. Somebody who's right track side. Woe Nelly has won. So congratulations to Woe Nelly and all of our great partners. If you want to come with us, take a few more pictures. You're not done. You're going to be famous. Thank you.
We are back here on WFTDA.TV for this gold medal matchup. It's Kansas City Roller Warriors versus Demolition City Roller Derby, and that was a fun halftime show. It's so much fun to come to the tournaments and see all this. I highly encourage everybody to come and visit the remaining tournaments we have this year.
Yeah, Hurricane Heather from Steel City putting on a jam skating show with their friends in Cleveland, Ohio. Raucous Ron, first half of that gold medal game. Kansas City getting it done so far, 73-45. The Division I team dropping into Division II, but looking to come away the champions of the first D2 of the year. Demolition City, traditional D2 team, perhaps getting a little bit of schooling in the first half.
That's right. Yeah, Kansas City, you know, former WFTDA champions, you know, now down in D2, doing some rebuilding here. But they've still got some of these veteran blockers that were there and yes. won it all. So that's a lot of experience then this team that they're coming up against. And they're really seeing that in the first half as some of their jammers who've had great success in this tournament, like Bambi Thumper, having a tough time getting through these Kansas City vaunted defensive walls.
Tough, tough blocking. Now, both of these teams have booked a ticket to St. Paul, Minnesota, championship weekend. The first place team will play against the second place team from the Detroit D2 next weekend. The second place team will play against the first place team from the Detroit D2 weekend. And then the winners of those games will face off on the Sunday. Losers will also face off for the bronze medal. Sunday, November 8th, tune into ESPN3 for day 3 of champs. You'll see both of these teams compete.
Oh my goodness, on ESPN3, we've been waiting for this for a long time, Bammo.
And if you are an international fan, you'll still be able to see all the action on WFTDA.TV as well. Penalties in that half, 28 for Demolition City, 14 for Kansas City. Quite the difference.
Oh, yeah.
And we saw that with
the
nonstop penalty parade to the DerbySupply.net penalty box. Scoring Kansas City with 22 points from Case Close, 19 points from A Pleasure, 12 points apiece from Turtle Power and Mary Lou Wretched. And on the Dynamite Doll side, it was Steffery with 21 and Bambi Thumper with 19. Lickety Splint chipping in with 4 before she went out with that hard hit. We haven't seen her return to jamming. Flexibel having a single point of her own. Only one really in penalty trouble is Bangs McCoy, number 22 from the Dynamite Dolls. She's sitting at 5 trips to the penalty box. Gonna have to be careful or her weekend will be done, but she will get to play one more time.
Yeah, Bangs McCoy, according to the stats, is one of the top 3 blockers for the Demolition City. And, you know, they really need her out there. So hopefully stay on the track. Kansas City really not in trouble penalty-wise, so that's great standing for them. We'll line up on the fast girl jam line with Steffery once again, and appropriately so, I think, jamming against Jessica Boom for Kansas City.
Slow start as we get the second half underway.
Jessica Boom trying to get the outside line, does. It's a nod from the referee. She stayed in bounds on the toe stops, is coming around the track into contention for points.
Tough Noogie's heading to the penalty box on her third trip.
Now getting some tough blocking from Bangs McCoy in the back, but able to weave through. Now going chest to chest on that. Boy, look at Jessica Boom, just really grinds hard, decides to call it off, but it may have been too late.
She does grab a 3, but gives up 2, so one bonus point going to Kansas City there. Now it's 76, Demolition City at 47, 29 minutes and 20 seconds remaining in this gold medal matchup from Cleveland, Ohio, the first D2 of the 10th anniversary playoff season for the WFTDA team that was at the very first WFTDA playoff. Kansas City Roller Warriors looking to come away with that medal.
That's right. Case closed for Kansas City. Bambi Thumper, both in turn one. Bambi Thumper gets a line, but oh, Enigma shuts the door on the line. Lots of skaters going down, and we have a lead jammer. That is Case getting up slow from the outside of turn 3.
Yeah, it looked like her leg gave out a little bit when she got up, but she's skating just fine right now. And Bambi Thumper being greeted by those blockers of Kansas City. Little bit of difference when the blockers are D1 level.
That's right. Now steps to the outside and gets a cut track drawn by Enigma, the master of that. So Case closed, battling alone as the pack extends out around the corner. Case is pushing. Case always making motion, very rarely stopped for very long, continues that very, you know, a lot of perseverance. Is encouraged to call it off.
Yeah, gonna call it off, freezing the jammer in the derbysupply.net penalty box. Roll faster and farther with Quick Ceramic Bearings. Quick, part of the Rydell family. We're gonna get A Pleasure onto the line. Case closed, sitting at 27 points. A Pleasure with 19 points. She will get a power start. Only person in the penalty box is Bambi Thumper. And don't forget, if you want to talk to us, hashtag talk2WFTDA on the Twitters.
Reptar jumping in, finds a hole, and is through. Wow, almost taken out by a foot as she comes out of the pack. And now lead coming around into turn 1. Comes up against the wall, gets some help from Romp Wrecker, creating some space to the outside. Stays on her toes, steps back to the inside. Chesting up once again. Just excellent blocking from Flex A. Bell, but holding that one, great one-on-one turnaround blocker. Yes. Flex A. Bell, but Reptar gets the better, and now the points.
The Dynamite Doll's just having a lot of trouble getting their top jammer through. Bambi Thumper just getting stuffed in that pack.
Really needs some offensive help, and we saw that earlier in the tournament that she wasn't getting a lot of offense but didn't need it, and now that she needs it, it's not sure they know what to do.
Star pass to Shelby Payne will get her out of the pack for the Demolition Dolls. 3 points will be snagged as the jam gets called off. Kansas City now at 89, Demolition City remaining at 47, 26 minutes remaining in the game. Demolition City gonna have to start rolling the dice. They're gonna do that with Bangs McCoy. She's got 5 penalties already in this game, but she's gonna wear the star in her helmet. And she's going to go up against Turtle Power for Kansas City on that fast girl start line.
Yeah, interestingly, they had eight jams in a row to end the first half with only using Steffery and Bambi Thumper. Right now, Turtle Power being drawn back into turn four. Bangs McCoy fighting two up front, but they're the two of the toughest out there, Accelerator and Burrs.
She does grab lead.
Well, they let her go on the front end. And Turtle Power with the pass of the star to former WFTDA tournament MVP, Accelerator.
She's greeted harshly by the tough blockers of Demolition City. Steel Stitches trying to bump her out of bounds.
Forearm penalty for someone in there, and that is Kansas City's jammer.
That was Accelerator with the forearm. The pivot turn jammer is in the penalty box. It's a power jam for Bangs McCoy.
Bangs McCoy into the mix, almost encouraged to cut track there in turn four, being drawn back. Bruise, Enigma, Turtle Power, Rump Wrecker stretched out for Kansas City.
Bruiser trying to get that last second cut on Bangs McCoy. Bangs having to do all the work herself, but she spins around, gets all 5 points, calls it off with Accelerator standing in the DerbySupply.net penalty box. It'll be a power start for Hertz Donut. Hertz Donut with no points in the first half, three trips to the penalty box. Demolition City going to roll the dice and put her back out there again in the second half. She is a regular part of the jammer rotation, but not a lot of success so far in this game. Fast Girl Skates, our mission is educating skaters. Get schooled at fastgirlskates.com. And on that Fast Girl start line, there goes Hertz Donut.
Hertz Donut looking for the outside line. Shut down quickly. Having a tough time with the outside with these Kansas City blockers, but now spins through for lead. Hertz Donut for Demolition City.
Power jam over Accelerator back on the track and quickly with a star pass. So it's Jessica Boom is the jammer right now. It's an illegal procedure.
Hertz Donut staying in bounds on the outside, picking up five. So some fresh legs on the track. Trying to mix it up, a different approach.
A little confusion on the part of Kansas City as the pivot is in the penalty box. They're not sure who the jammer is at the moment. Enigma with a nice pop out cycles Hertz Donut back. Enigma in 28 jams so far.
Wow, now we've got
everybody's back on the track. Kansas City's still trying to figure out who their jammer is at the moment, though.
Yep. Star getting passed around out there. Went from Jessica Boom, the pivot, back to Accelerator.
Another illegal procedure. Another illegal star pass, I believe.
Yeah, I wasn't sure if that was legal when I saw it myself.
So Accelerator is heading back to the DerbySupply.net penalty box. She was the jammer. She's back for another trip. She's in there for her fourth visit. And it will be another power start. Case closed is out there for Kansas City at the moment. Steffery wearing the star. We're going to get an official timeout. Get things all cleared up.
Got a shout out here from Kansas City. This is Redbeard. Says, I'm so proud of you, meaning myself, our league, and my love, Rump Wrecker.
Thank you. And you can talk to us at hashtag talk2WFTDA. You can also follow us at WFTDA Live, WFTDA Playoff. And if you missed out on our exclusive 2014 Playoffs and Championships merchandise, you can complete your collection at the WFTDA online store, WFTDA.com/store. Lots of great things from last season, and lots of great things are going to happen this season. Next weekend, the D2 in Detroit will be happening. Again, for $12, you can watch the whole darn weekend, 17 games. If you missed this weekend, you have no idea how exciting it has been. And then don't forget that the Tucson, Dallas, Jacksonville, Omaha D1s will be coming very quickly after that, along with championships. You can get that as a package deal for only $60. Mm. So much roller derby, your family will wonder where you've gone.
And that is highly recommended from the Twitterverse. Cleveland Newser says, this crew has been making Derby sound good all weekend.
Just clarification from Patricide about the penalty. How Accelerator was sitting in the penalty box because of the illegal star pass. That is why this will be a power jam. Now, 4-on-4 blocking core out there. All the hard hitters for Kansas City are going to try to stop Steffery. Steffery, with 23 points in this game, has been a clutch player.
Yeah, definitely Steffery creating holes, giving this team hope to catch up. Not too far down really right now, 89-67, and about to make up some more of that difference. Is Steffery coming into the pack, into turn two, from the outside to the inside.
And for such a physical blocker, when she turns a jammer, she's a little more delicate and much more cautious as she tumbles to the ground.
But powerful nonetheless, slicing through some heads hitting each other there. Looking back to the referee and says, where was my high block call?
Accelerator out of the penalty box, back on the track.
Nice push out there from the aforementioned Rump Wrecker.
And Enigma picking up her third penalty of the game. Jam called off. 5 points for Demolition City. That will get them to 77. Kansas City remaining at 89. The difference is now 12 minutes. How quickly the gap closes. 30 points over the last three jams for Demolition City. And suddenly we've got ourselves a really close game once again, Ron.
Yeah, you got to think they went to the locker room and came out with a plan of attack here. Maybe some good coaching going on. Give props to all our coaches out there in Derbyland. A skating case closed. Kansas City, Bangs McCoy, Demolition City into turn one. Coming into turn two. Packed tight together. Case closed. Pushing the front wall.
And a forearm to Bangs McCoy sends her to the DerbySupply.net penalty box. Momentum shift.
Mm-hmm. So many jammer penalties in this game. For Demolition City.
Yeah, not what Demolition City needed after that 30-point run. Power jam, Kansas City.
Case looking for the outside. Boys, that was a setup right there. Really loving the jamming the blocking that I'm seeing for Flexa Bell. Just smart moves, willing to take anybody on head-to-head. Case closed, trying to work the inside. Now coming up against Flexibel and company, but gets help from Lady Killshot. The rookie all-star from Kansas City creates the hole with the one-on-one block, and you gotta love that if you're a Kansas City fan.
She's got a big smile on her face on the track right now. Illegal procedure, splatter coming onto the track in an improper position from the penalty box.
Lady Killshot coming from another style of derby and making an excellent transition this year mid-season.
Bangs McCoy completing that first pass after getting over the penalty box.
Case closed, will call it off. Falling to a knee.
Absorbs one last hit from Jetsy Rockette. 20 points is the gap now as Kansas City gets their way to 97. Demolition City at 77. 19 minutes remaining in this game. The championship bout. The winner gets the gold. The loser gets the silver. Both get to go to championship weekend in St. Paul, Minnesota.
Oh, yeah.
Both will be seen on ESPN 3.
They just want that gold right here. It's gold or silver.
It's all about winning right now.
Bragging rights.
Hurts doing it in APA pleasure.
Yep. Picking up another jammer penalty for the cut track. That was drawn by Bruce once again. Loves to run backwards and get the other jammer off the track. A pleasure spinning by the front block of Flexibel.
Hurts doing it just hitting the penalty box now. So 30 seconds for Kansas City on the power jam.
A pleasure now engaged with the wall. Goes down hard. Here's some whistles coming from turn three. That'll be splatter headed to the penalty box. Pat gets separation. Bridging out wide, a pleasure. There's this battle again up front with the turnaround blocking.
That's Flexibel's specialty. Splatter with her sixth trip to the penalty box. That was a back block.
Amazing how you can come in here into WFDA playoffs and make a name for yourself in one tournament. Reptar battling two, stays in bounds on the curve. Excellent footwork earned turn four to grab five more, extending Kansas City's lead to 20.
That was Steel Stitches and lickety-split out of the jammer rotation, doing a decent job of blocking out there, though.
30.
Flexibel to the DerbySupply.net penalty box. Joined by Bruiser.
Now drawn back deep into turn four by Splatter. Is Reptar. Hertz Donut. And driven to the ground. Blocking with the head called on someone in there. That is going to be
Hertz Donut. Fifth trip to the DerbySupply.net penalty box.
That
jammer rotation is not coming through for Demolition City at the moment. 5 points for A Pleasure. That gets Kansas City to 112. Official timeout is being called. 77 for Demolition City. Checking to see if it is a timeout for Kansas City or Demolition City. That is their second time out of the game. They have one remaining plus their official review. Clock is sealed at 16 minutes and 42 seconds remaining in this game.
And Demolition City has gone five jams without putting Bambi Thumper out there, which is rather unusual.
It is. You got to wonder if there's something going on the bench. What's happening on the track and in the penalty box, Bangs McCoy is at six trips to the penalty box. Hertz doing that with
dangerous
five trips and Splatter with six trips. So Dynamite Doll's in danger of losing some skaters. All five of those trips for Hertz Donut were there as a jammer. Over on the Kansas City side, only Enigma is in any kind of danger at all. Four trips to the penalty box. That's over 31 jams. Rump record with 25, Bruiser with 27. A Pleasure with 42 points in this game. Case closed with 35 over on the Dynamite Dolls. 33 for Steffery. Bambi Thumper with 19, but as we just said, she has not been seen recently. Hertz Donut remains in the penalty box. Jessica Boom is going to be the jammer for Kansas City.
Jessica Boom really likes to be physical coming into the pack. Very aggressive against these veteran skaters on the track, driven to the ground by Flexibel, who's then sealed off in retreat by Enigma. Flexibel picking up the cut track after knocked to the ground by Enigma.
That's her fourth trip to the DerbySupply.net penalty box, and the lead jammer has been achieved by Jessica Boom.
Jessica knocked to the outside.
Track
cut called.
Just as Hertz Donut was released from the penalty box, we get a star pass to Steffery.
Steffery very powerful and effective as a jammer and a blocker for that matter. So the all-around derby skater, Steffery.
Gets out of the pack, not lead jammer, not able to achieve that because of the star pass. Steffery working her way through the pack. Hard blocking three wall, turns into a two wall. Now only one blocker remaining at the front of the pack. Dueling with Bruiser, she'll get through for five. Power jam is over. Jessica Boom out of the penalty box.
Jessica Boom engaged. Pushing, gets by, picks up four for Kansas City.
Flexibel with trip number five now. Steffery easily through that time, picks up 4 points.
And still 15 minutes remaining in this one. Jessica Boom knocked to the outside.
Shelby and Payne not able to get back on the drawback.
Shelby and Payne and company collapsing on the floor. Yep, low block called.
Jetsy Rockette. Might have blown a skate as well.
And coming around, Steffery was looking for the high block penalty, holding the face, a little frustrated there. Referee shook the head no
4 points aside. Steffery still complaining about it, nodding her head, heading back to the bench. 124 for Kansas City. Demolition City at 90. 34 points separate the teams. 14 minutes and 24 seconds remaining in the game. My Bonts, the latest and greatest way to customize your Bonts skates.
And now,
Bont.com.
And now Bambi Thumper stepping back in after a break from the action. Maybe one to let her settle down a little bit.
See if she can get through this tenacious blocking of Kansas City.
A very diminutive jammer, and that has been to her favor this whole tournament, but maybe not here against these big blockers for Kansas City, who are also very agile. Forearm penalty on Kansas City's Turtle Power. Will sit down in the box, and
offense in effect by Demolition City. They're going to get Bambi Thumper, and she does not call it off incorrectly this time.
Yeah, I've made that mistake before, but this time looks a little bit longer at the bench to let the coach make that call. And now coming around, looking for position around the track, does not get past Enigma.
Enigma with a forearm.
Now Bambi Thumper looking back to her bench. They're saying, go ahead, but no.
You know what? It wasn't Enigma with the forearm. It was Mayhem Myers that got the forearm.
And the inside pack ref was saying, no, there was a forearm that caused it. And the inside ref said, no, it was a cut track.
Yep.
So we'll see. Maybe she saw something that the outside pack ref did not see. Maybe this one will see a challenge. I don't know.
I would not be surprised. A pleasure now trying to. No,
oh,
sorry.
That's Turtle Power.
Crashing to the ground and getting up quickly again.
And now knocked to the outside. This is a tournament rookie right here. Passing off the star to Bruce.
Whoa, huge hit by Tough Noogies. Forearm sending her to the box.
Tough Noogies, one of the biggest hitters in the game, and back onto the track and wrapping around. Oh, no, a forearm on Bruce.
Star pass not working out for Kansas City.
Kansas City only had a 4% star pass ratio this year, so not very, they don't do it very often, so maybe not very experienced at it. That was a crazy jam, Bammo.
It was. Demolition City at 95, Kansas City at 124. 29 points separate these teams. And we're going to have a power start with Steffery on the line. Steffery with 46 points. Normally a regular in the blocking rotation. She's had to put the star on because she's one of the only jammers that's able to get through.
Now, those are in the second half, too, aren't they, mostly?
She had some in the first half. She got brought into the jammer rotation near the end as she and Bambi Thumper started going 1-2, 1-2. But she's remained in the jammer rotation.
A little bit of a reset on this one.
Yep.
Maybe a whistle was blown before the refs were ready or something, I will hypothesize.
Yeah, that DerbySupply.net has been getting heavy use by both sides in the second half. All your derby needs, DerbySupply.net. Just hit it. Just checking to see what the official timeout was all about. We'd like to give some thanks to Sin City Skates and Something Inked. Thank you from the WFDDA.
Looks like everyone is ready now.
11 minutes, 37 seconds left in the game. 29 points separating the teams. The power jam is on. 3-on-2 pack advantage for Demolition City.
So much going on in this one. Steffery will come up against the two for Kansas City. Oh, breaks him down quickly with a shoulder. Sometimes power is better than quickness, and there's an example.
Steffery just really coming
Boom,
through for
hits
the team.
Enigma and takes her to the ground. You hardly ever see that, Bammo.
Exploded her off her skates.
Yeah, and that's the risk of turning around face to face.
Too hot that time.
A back block penalty comes in hot, and another jammer penalty, and that might be one of the stories of the game, but still only 24 points between the teams. So.
Yeah,
anybody's game, really.
If you're going to go physical as a jammer, you got to be really sure you're picking that legal target zone, because skaters are going to fall down when Steffery hits them.
Oh, yeah. Solid hitter. And now the star pass. Nope.
The star stash. Bruiser still has the star and is going to get out of the pack. Finally, one last hit from Shelby and Payne.
puts it on. Coming around into position. Will she get in the offense? Nuggies fooled him! Nuggies looked like gonna feign to crush the pack, and they collapsed, opening up that outside lane for Bruce.
Steffery out of the belly boss getting through as well.
And getting up slowly is Nuggies, and then leaving the track on a penalty. So Steffery coming around, scoring points, closing the differential.
Four more for Demolition City, four more for Kansas City. Jam going the full 2 minutes, 15 seconds remaining in it. Steffery coming up against the front. Multiplayer block. Going to send Enigma to the DerbySupply.net penalty box. Steffery with another four. Time running out in this jam. No additional points for Kansas City. Demolition City at 108, Kansas City at 132. 9.5 minutes.
Wow, Heathen on Twitter says this game is going to give me a heart condition. Wow.
I
Knox says,
you.
Eek, come on, Demo, reset and steady yourselves, and you can still have a chance.
Blockers from Kansas City sitting in that DerbySupply.net penalty box, two of them, so it's going to be a 4-on-2 pack advantage when the jam gets underway. When the Fast Girls start, line is going to be Bambi Thumper giving it another go, maybe with only two blockers out there. She'll find a little bit more real estate, able to use that textbook agility and speed. Penalties so far in this game, Demolition City with 42, Kansas City with 31.
Very much the difference in the game with the score. 20 points between them.
And
Enigma, that is a big deal.
Enigma is now at 6 penalties in this game. She has played in 36 jams so far. That is every jam in this game.
Once again, Enigma does not leave the track, and how many skaters can say that?
But the question is that if she fouls out, and she's been such a leader on the track, such a force out there, what is Kansas City going to do to replace her?
Well, it happened yesterday with 10 minutes remaining, and they were able to maintain against Houston.
Head ref patricide. We'll try to get clarification on that official timeout for you.
So Kansas City with three blockers that stay in almost all the time, and you've got that for Demolition City too with Bangs McCoy, Shelby and Payne, and Steph Ree. They were each in over 250 jams this season, and that's far above any other teammates. Back on the floor, case closed, jamming for Kansas City, trying to get the front opening, but through the rabbit hole is Bambi Thumper.
And Bambi Thumper happy to have only two blockers on the track, really making speed around.
Now coming into the pack, but case closed, closing as well, and 0 points for
Kansas City.
To be both.
And Cataclysm is going to have to check with DJ Jazzy Ref, the outside pack ref, to see if any hips were passed. The answer is no.
Yeah, it looked like was knocked out right in the back of the pack, so got to get the hips around.
Double H has a clarification for us.
So you'll notice that Demolition City now has 112 points. Mm-hmm. That is because in the last jam, the white jammer went out with 4 points in her pocket, came out, and was waived as not lead when she should have been awarded points for her scoring pass.
I did notice that. I did not comment on it because I did not want to overrule the referees, but a pleasure resetting. Hertz Donut out there again for Demolition City with 5 trips to the box.
Wow, and gets through almost. Gets lead, gets knocked down now, recycled back into the pack. Kansas City so good at cycling blockers to the front of the pack and holding them in, but again, coming through this time on the inside of turn two is Hertz Donut, and a big shove out.
Steel stitches.
Steel stitches, that is excellent right there. You've got to make every good move right now in this game and pull back in. Still only down by 20, so not a crisis, but
time running out though.
Yeah.
7.5 minutes left in the game. Direction of gameplay is going to send Lady Killshot to the DerbySupply.net penalty box. A pleasure cycled back one more time, this time by Lickety Splint. But the track cut forced.
Wow.
By Enigma. Trip number 6.
Track cut master Enigma. So a direction of gameplay there on the boss. And taking a shirt whip is a pleasure. Coming around now, facing off. What a juke move to the inside pass. Splatter in turn two. I splattered my tongue there.
Almost 90 seconds for A Pleasure to get out of the pack. She still has 25 seconds to work in this jam. She is not lead. That was Hertz Donut, who still sits in the penalty box.
Now staying inbounds on the inside of the straightaway, picking up five. Splatter to the penalty box. Reptar on the toe stop. So smartly steps back out of bounds.
Jam's going to time out. Three additional points picked up by Kansas City. Three additional points picked up by Demolition City. 6 minutes and 10 seconds remaining in this game. Kansas City with a 21-point lead, 141 to 120 over Demolition City. And
Kansas City's got to keep the wheels on the bus.
Heart palpitations are both sides.
Yeah, they've maintained control, and you know, they've had some crazy jams where they've lost a bunch of points,
yep.
But they have to avoid doing that now with 5 minutes left.
Performance plates for the Modern Derby game, Powerdyne. Powerdyne.
And what do you think? This should be the strategy here. Okay, you're a great strategist and coach. And what do you think that Demolition City needs to do to pull back into this one?
Ron, I hate to be the obvious person, but keep your jammer on the track.
Yes. Yeah.
I think Demolition City is competing when both jammers are on the track. They're
That's
able
right.
to get points, but the power jams are killing them. Every time they get momentum, they are just getting caught up one more time. They've just been unable to really find an opportunity to keep things flowing. They'll close that gap a bit and then give up a penalty. Close the gap a bit, give up another penalty.
Yeah, and you get the feeling that they're not as experienced. We mentioned it before,
right,
with this level of blockers that you're getting, these heavy hitter D1 blockers for Kansas City, tough noogies, Rump Wrecker, Bruce Her, Enigma, and company, really holding back Bambi Thumper in this game.
13 jammer penalties so far for the Dynamite Dolls, only 7 for Kansas City, 6 extra power jams for Kansas City.
The wow.
difference, only 21 points on the scoreboard.
You'd think it'd be more than that
you
with
really,
that big of a
really
difference.
Really would. So again, I will stress, and I know it seems obvious, if the Dynamite Dolls want to win this, they need to get their jammer on the track. It's Steffery, and it is a power jam, Ron.
Yeah, Steffery pushing and getting separation. Will draw a forearm penalty on Rump Wrecker.
Enigma has fouled out, by the way, Ron. She does have 7 trips, so that changes the defensive spectrum.
Well, it was in for 38 straight jams, and just play all the way down to the not the dirty end, but Steffery picking up 5.
Now 16 points is the gap. Power jam is over as A Pleasure is out of the box.
Referee telling her blockers to go get them, go attack, but now attacking when Noogie's knocking her to the ground. She will call it off.
Steffery calling off the jam, looking for the points. 5 more points, a 10-point jam. Double H, you have some clarification on that last jam timeout.
Bit of confusion at the end of the last jam before this pass jam, where actually Reptar had committed a cutting the track penalty and it had been assessed late, so they needed to make sure they got her into the box.
Thank you very much, Double H. We'd also like to thank you to DerbySupply.net, helping to bring the WFDA.TV broadcast to your home. Case closed, going up against Bambi Thumper.
Bambi Thumper diving into the pack, knocked down. Huge hit from Bruce. And now,
so Bambi Thumper had lead. Case closed, got out. Jam gets called off. And we're going to get some discussion among the referees once again. Official timeout, or actually timeout called by Demolition City. 4 minutes and 14 seconds left in this game. It is an 11-point gap that Demolition City needs to make out. Kansas City still at 141, Demolition City at 130.
And what a story it would be for Demolition City down the entire game to come back and win this one over Kansas City. That would be an amazing story.
Yep.
But in Kansas City, you know, they have played strong. They have done a great job in this of maintaining the pack control. Just they deserve, both these teams deserve to win this. Can we have two winners?
I think everybody wins because they're playing Derby.
Everybody wins because they're all going to St. Paul, Minnesota.
This is true. They will get to go to Champs.
That is a big change this year, and I really like it.
Steffery is taking the star once again. Steffery had 73 points for Demolition City. She's picked up this team on her back and is carrying it forward. The blocker is doing a great job. She's doing the majority of the jamming work in this second half.
Extraordinary. Case closed. Steffery coming down here to just a two or three jams. Steffery looking for the outside. Pushing hard. Case closed. Picking up lead. Stays in bounds. Steffery recycled back in. That is the rookie kill shot on the recycle. Case closed into scoring position, looking to extend the lead, coming up against Steel Stitches. And the Demo front line now facing off with Flex Abel. Steffery
gets out of the pack. She absorbed massive hits throughout that pack and looks completely calm when she exits it.
Case closed, going to let time run down, coming into the pack. Will not call it off, continuing the jam, letting Steffery get in scoring position. Now, case closed, knocked down. Kansas City relying on the defense back there to hold Steffery.
Star pass going to Shelby and Vidiucic.
Star pass, apex jump, unsuccessful. That's a lot to do in one turn.
Shelby and Payne say hello to Tough Noogies. Tough Noogies with six trips to the box already, too.
That was pretty tricky maneuver. It would have been interesting if it had worked, but Tough Noogies, all the veteran.
Shelby and Payne not giving up, though.
Wow, 5-4 Case. Case will let the clock continue to roll, matching point for point here. Ambrose with the takedown in turn four of Steffery. Case closed, coming up against the four wall, slices through the middle of it and takes off.
Shelby and Payne trying to find a gap as time ticks down in this jam.
Shelby and Payne really seem locked down defense for Kansas City right now. One of the stories of the game. Now coming through, but all the way around, and whoa-bammo.
Yeah, whoa-bammo indeed. 2 minutes remaining in this game. Kansas City with a darn important jam on that.
That's
jam.
Right.
161 to Demolition City's 138. 23 points separate these teams. The penalties are now 39 for Kansas City, 46 for DC. So Kansas City rapidly climbing the penalty ladder, but not much time left in this game. We're in last jam territory, and it's actually underway. Babby Thumper against A-Pleasure.
And A-Pleasure looking to avoid a penalty and finds a hole. Wonderful move by the young skater.
Now the question is Kansas City going to play it cautious here? They've got the penalty clock under, or the period clock under control. They could just run it out, but not playing it safe at all. A-Pleasure into the pack.
And sailing through on the scoring pass for 5 is A-Pleasure. Bambi Thumper out of the pack in scoring position as well. Get the feeling though.
At this point, virtually the only way that Demolition City can lose is if A-Pleasure gets a penalty.
And a low block called for Kansas City.
A-Pleasure going to re-engage one more time.
Time running out, under a minute on the period clock, in control. It's Kansas City, period clock less than the jam clock, so A-Pleasure can pretty much sit back and let this one ride. Not enough time to score enough points here, I'm thinking.
So the Kansas City fans telling her just to disengage. It is a smart maneuver. Victory is within reach, only 20 seconds away. Raucous Ron.
And Bruce coming back and pointing over to the clock saying, look at this, look what we've got. And then Kansas City playing tough defense. Bruce recycling Bambi Thumper. Hope running out here for Demolition City, but what a game. What a game, Bammo. Kansas City Rollers victorious Unofficial final right now.
There goes the whistles. Reptar was waiting on those, on that hip tap. She was celebrating with her fans in the stand. But yeah, the hands go to the hip. Kansas 61 City.
61 points for A Pleasure. Reptar lighting up the scoreboard in this one for Kansas City.
Yeah. Wow. Impressive performance by both teams. Kansas City getting it done. Demolition City pushing very hard at the end of the game. The last couple of jams, the Roller Warriors came to life one more time. You look at the blocker rotation, the jams that people played. Enigma, 37 jams. Rump Wrecker, 32. Bruiser, 34 jams. And Tough Noogie, 27. Tough Noogie's actually fouling out in that last jam.
Wow. And Kansas City fans rushing it up.
Yeah, they just won the gold medal. I mean,
wow, so happy on the floor. And Demolition City fans, you've got to be so proud of your team. They really came here to play, played their hearts out.
Yes.
Had three, ending up with six penalties at the end of the game. Hertz Donut, Bangs McCoy, and Flex Abel just playing right down to the wire to make that four with Splatter as well. And big props now coming around, getting congratulated by Demolition City. Big smiles and sportsmanship on both sides, Bamo.
Yeah, the victory lap underway for the Kansas City Roller Warriors. Fantastic effort on both sides. What a great weekend.
Really?
The first weekend of the 2015 season, playoff season. The 10th playoff season for the WFDDA. If you watched it all weekend long, you were treated to many spectacular bouts. This last
so
one, the
many,
championship
so
bout. Oh, yes.
Yeah.
The championship bout, no different at all. Heart-stopping action. And, of course, we'll go home after this and do it all again next weekend, starting on Friday, the Detroit D2.
I know.
The 2015 International WFDDA Division II playoffs continuing next weekend. But the winners of this weekend,
yes,
the Kansas
right.
City Roller Warriors
and
defeating the Demolition City Roller Derby Dynamite Dolls, Raucous Ron.
And then four big D1 tournaments.
Oh, yeah.
All leading into St. Paul, Minnesota. And again, you've got to go to these tournaments. Pick a tournament, go to it. It's great stuff. The energy is electrifying in here. You know, so much positive derby energy flowing from the crowd. So much love. So,
Ron, it's been a pleasure. We're going to go to some commercials and we'll get the awards ceremony when we come back.